It's the Winemakers on Sporting News, presented by Jack Daniel's.
Folks, get your pen and paper out. It's one of our featured games of the week, the Thursday night standalone game. New York Giants at Carolina. Brian Blessing with Kenny White. Kenny, the game opened 1.5. Giants favorite. It's down to 1. Total open 52. Bet me under. It's down to 51. But take that with a grain of salt because it's such a ridiculously high total.
We got two quarterbacks that can sling it around, Brian. Last week, Eli Manning, 510 yards passing. It wasn't a comeback effort, but this Giant team does start slow.
How do we put our finger on what goes on with the Giants in regard to that? They start slow, but in the fourth quarter, Eli Manning's as good as it gets.
I have to believe that Tom Coughlin has become a player's coach. After all these years of being the dictator, I think he's finally settled into being a nice guy, just teaching the game. And it's really affected this team early in the season.
Listen, this is the kind of information you're going to get all year long here at the Linemakers on Sporting News. Kenny had great information on Tom Coughlin at home. He's an overcoach, except when they're playing division foes, and that reaped rewards in the opener against Dallas. So pay attention. Kenny's got some pretty good numbers with Tom Coughlin when the Giants hit the road.
Well, very strong on the road. Tom Coughlin, 35-16 ATS when he gets his team out of the city.
Let's go to the Carolina Panthers. Kenny, this is a team, they had a hard-fought contest early on, and Cam Newton was actually contained, but he got it going last week against New Orleans. But you've got telling numbers from his rookie year, how he started and how he maybe tailed off a little, but people didn't realize it.
I think people got to learn a little bit more about Cam Newton as the season progressed. He averaged 346 passing yards a game the first four games of the season. The last eight games of the season, Cam Newton averaged 207. Now, he's gotten off to a good start this year, but against two very weak defenses. I think the Giant pass rush will give him problems.
All right, down the road, trust me, there's going to be some big-time money-making information for you with all these Thursday night games that are going to be played. The first one was Green Bay-Chicago. That game went under the total, but I think you got to look, that was a playoff game for Green Bay, so it was kind of played at that intensity level. Here you got a quick turnaround. You say the offenses, you believe, are ahead of the curve here.
Well, it's less time for the defense to prepare for each offense. So advantage to the offense. Cam Newton, as I said, I think he'll struggle against a better defense, but the Giants secondary has been so weak. He could put up a lot of yards late in the game if he's behind.
All right, let's saddle up and take a stand on something. I'll just throw maybe one, it's not off the wall because it's on the board here in Las Vegas. I think maybe a safe play is Carolina in the first half because for whatever reason, the Giants just keep starting slow. You'd make that number pick?
It'd be a pick 'em, yes.
All right, and how about you for the game?
Well, for the game, I'm going to go with the Giants. I think the Giants are the side in this one. I like your first half bet. That's the beauty about sports. You can bet the first half, second half, or the game.
Well, you could maybe do Carolina first half, Giants second half, too.
You bet the second half if the Giants are behind.
A lot of ways to go. Kenny's got it covered. We have you covered. The Linemakers on Sporting News. Enjoy the Thursday night game with the Giants visiting Carolina to take on the Panthers.